In this video, I will show you how to create cinematic shots using only Blender so your renders could look like movies. And it's really easy because I developed a simple pipeline that anyone that knows a little bit of Blender will be able to follow. So I will not show you how to create this scene step by step, rather I will guide you on what you need to focus on your future projects. Thanks to that, you will not only be able to recreate this project, but also any other shot. And it all starts with composition. To start with anything, we need to look for reference, see how movies are framed, but also remember probably the most important thing is the story. Humans love stories, so your shot needs to tell something, otherwise it's just a pointless photo. So you need to come up with a story for your shot. To give you an example, in this project I'm creating an epilogue to this scene where our hero managed to escape the gang and she's taking a break to think about her life while smoking a cigarette. And you also need to think of a backstory for your shot. You need to think about what do you want to tell your audience. So with that, think about your shot, look for reference and open Blender. Now you might notice that movies are filmed around 1.85 by 1 ratio, so to get that filmic look, change your resolution to 1920 by 810 pixels or 3840 by 1620 if you're animating in 4K. Also, if you're making an animation, make sure to keep the frame rate to 24 frames per second and shutter speed to 0.5 in the motion blur settings. Also, add an mist pass and set the correct numbers. Now we can create your shot. When you're done, we can move on to lighting, because even if you make a perfect shot but it's poorly lit, your shot is gonna look like shit. So let's move on to step 2, lighting. Most of the movies are using 3-point lighting method, and I think most of you know that. What I want to emphasize is how believable the lights need to be. Let me explain. Look at this. I was wondering why this looks fake. I used the 3-point lighting method, but it still looks wrong. But why? Well, the answer is that the lights have no justification. These two lights don't have the actual reason to be there. So the easiest way to fix that is by adding a source. But when I added a lamp, it ruined my composition, and maybe you also don't want a giant lamp in your scene, so we'll have to get creative. So let's see what we can work with here. We have these lights on the back of the car, so we can zoom out a bit and turn them on. Thanks to that, we have a justification to change the fill light to red, giving us more interesting silhouette of the character. Also, we can lower the power of the main light as well as the rim light, even though this one is justified. Now listen, because this is important. Lights help us indicate where the audience should be looking. Naturally, when something is brighter, we are looking at it. So we need to guide our audience on where they should focus. In this case, I used a cigarette to show the audience where the most important part of the scene is. So you should treat lightning as a way to focus the audience on a specific part of the frame. Because when you think about it, the main light and the rim light don't make much sense, but that's how the scene looks without them. So as an artist, you need to make decisions on what's more important to you, realism or artistic direction. Also, a quick tip, volume scatter helps your colors pop much more. With that out of the way, we can render our shot and move on to the last thing that can make or break our work, which is compositing. So I do my compositing in Nuke, but I said that we'll be using Blender for this tutorial, so I will try to recreate most of the effects that I do in Nuke. But for those who want to start compositing in Nuke, this tutorial is a great place to start. So there are a few things that help a shot feel more cinematic. Grain, lens distortion, colors, and depth of field. Also, this is the part where I will tell you step by step what to do, so let's start with the last one. Simply add an empty. Enable depth of field in the camera settings, set the focus object on your empty, and position it where you want to have an area of focus. Set the blaze to 6 and ratio to 2 to have that anamorphic look. Set the f-stop however you like, and the depth of field is ready. Now we can press render. After your scene has rendered, go to compositing and enable use nodes. Add a viewer node to know what you're doing. Let's start with the mist pass. Add a blur node and an RGB node and connect the RGB node to the blur node. Then add a mix node and set it to add. Plug the image node to the first dot and a blurred node to the second one. Add color ramp node and plug the mist pass to the factor. Now we can control how much mist do you want in your scene with a color ramp node and the color of it with an RGB node. Now we can focus on the colors. Add RGB curves node and color balance, The first node controls how bright or dark the image is, and color balance controls the color. I mainly use the first slider, so choose the values to your liking. After that is done, we'll focus on the thing that will massively improve our render, lens distortion effects. So to start, add a glare node, set it to fog glow and high level of detail, keep the mix and threshold to around 0.1, but play with it. Same with the size. Later, add a lens distortion node and also set the values to something small. But don't forget to experiment. Remember to check fit. And now we are almost done, but there is one last thing that is often overlooked, which is grain. People think it's useless because it hides some details, so why use it? Well, watch any movie and you will quickly see that this is how cameras work. So it's very important to remember this effect, and fortunately it's very easy to do in Blender. To start, go to texture panel and add a noise texture. Name it grain. And also check the clamp box. Go back to the compositing tab, add a texture node, blur node and a mix node. In the texture node, select our grain texture. Plug the whole thing to the blur node. Change the X value to 1 and Y to 2. Connect it to the mix node, set it to multiply and change the factor to around 0.15. Then plug lens distortion to the mix node and enjoy. Our render is looking much better than before and it doesn't really look that much different from the one I made in Nuke. So that's the simple pipeline on how to create cinematic shots in Blender. Subscribe to my channel if you want more tutorials like this and let me know about what. But if you are a beginner in 3D and want to know how to learn Blender much faster, watch this video.